for connecting today with my Facebook Live. I've been looking forward to speak to you for quite some time, but now the moment has come. I'll do it as often as I possibly can. So I trust that you will be blessed. I want to speak about something today that I would call an elementary Christian truth. It's not complicated. It's not simplistic, but it is simple. And I believe you're going to be blessed as I walk you through the wonderful Word of God. I've opened here at 1 Corinthians chapter 1, and it is the 18th verse. The 18th verse. 1 Corinthians 1, verse 18. For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. That's, for me, one of the most wonderful truths in Scripture. To those who perish, the message of the cross, which is the gospel, is foolishness. But to us who are saved, it is and remains the power of God. And I pray that this miracle may happen here within the next few minutes to so very many people. I see you are, I see your comments are flying past. I see somebody's watching from Malaysia. Wow, Malaysia. And if it's not specially mentioned, South Africa, I can see there is a flag of South Africa. And Scott Self, God bless you, my dear brother. And oh, wow, it's wonderful. Please make sure that your friends are also connected, because they will truly be edified and strengthened and blessed. I want to thank all of you who responded to my message yesterday. It was something like a roll call. I don't do it often, but maybe in 2 years or so, or 3 years, I did one yesterday. And I asked all those who watch me to just let me know, even if it's just 3 words. But, you know, I break the bread of life to you to encourage you. And believe it or not, I sometimes also need a little encouragement for those who are blessed, because it speeds me on. It gives me wings and gives me lift. I want to feed the flock, as Jesus told me to do. I see from Zambia, I see Nigeria, I see Pakistan. God bless you, my dear brother from Pakistan. Oh, God bless you, God bless you. Okay, now I'm starting. For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Now, before I start, forgive me if I just say something else. Before I am done here, I'm going to pray for the sick. And I believe that the Holy Spirit will come and will touch you wherever in the world you are. And I'm exercising the authority that God has given to me this very moment. In the name of Jesus, every barrier and hindrance be broken, and there shall be a full flow of the power of the Holy Spirit right from here in Florida, the United States, to wherever you are on in God's great world. Now, really, let me start like this. It's many years ago. I was preaching in the church in Germany, and I was waiting for the time for me to come to preach. The pastor made the introduction and all the things that needed to be done. And suddenly, as I sat there and I looked at the pulpit and the back of the church, I saw an empty cross there, an empty cross, just empty. No crucifix, nobody hanging there. I like the empty cross because Jesus is no more hanging on the cross. He was buried and then he rose again, and he sits now at the right hand of the Father. He still remains our crucified Savior, the one who was buried and the one who is alive now forevermore. God bless you, brother from Dubai. I can see your comment just passing on. Sudan, God bless you. Jane, God bless you. Oh, hallelujah. Now, I suddenly saw something I had never seen before. I saw that the cross consists of two beams, one vertical and one horizontal, crossing through the vertical. And it was as if the Holy Spirit touched my eyes and I realized, wow, these are two beams, wooden beams that make up the cross on which Jesus died. And then I knew. One beam was vertical. That is God's great I. I am He, Jesus said in the Garden of Gethsemane before he was arrested. I am He, God's I. And our part of the cross is the vertical one. The vertical beam. Why? Because very simply, it is in our world of mathematics, arithmetic, whatever you call it, it is the minus. And that is our part. Because we, human beings, were all sinners. We were born sinners. We didn't learn to sin. It's inherent. It's inherited. So we are all sinners, the Bible says, and come short of the glory of God. You see? So now comes the real thing. Jesus came into this world, sent by the Father, to save us, to redeem us, to pay the price for our redemption, which was to be paid by his precious blood. So how did that happen? Suddenly I could see it. I saw it right in front of me in the form of that cross. Jesus came to die in our stead. What did he do? He took our minus. He took our sorrows, our sins, our rejection, our bondage, our addictions, call it what you want, all evils. He took them. He took them. And outside of Jerusalem, he took our minus and was nailed to that cross, vertical and the horizontal beams which constitute the cross of Jesus Christ. And you know what happened? This is why I am so happy to be able to talk to you about it. When he took our minus and carried it to Calvary to be nailed against the vertical. He turned our minus into a plus. You get it? Our minus, your minus, my minus, he turned it into a plus. This is very profound, because this what happened at Calvary. And the good news to those to whom this message is foolishness, they will perish. This is what says 1 Corinthians 1 verse 18 says, they will perish eternally, which means they will go lost. They will go to hell. That's what the Bible says. I'm not speaking my opinion at all. I'm a servant of God and I tell you what the Bible says. But thankfully, it has got much, much more to say, and that's why I'm not yet finished. It's a plus. Jesus is here today. Listen, please. Jesus is here today to turn your sin into salvation. Your night into light. Your bondage into freedom. Your fears into living faith. Death into life and hell into heaven and chains into liberty. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. If you can receive it by faith, receive it by faith and say, Lord, I receive it. And I receive it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you blessed? Are you blessed? You see, what the cross means, there are so many different meanings that suddenly struck me that come through the cross. You know, let me give you one more. I alone, I am weak. But I plus the cross plus Jesus equal more than a conqueror. I'm quoting the Bible. He turns the weak into more than conquerors. Did you get that? Oh, if you can get that, you will be completely changed. Completely changed in 1 second. This is not evolution, this is revolution. This is not just some slow process. It is liberation. Instant liberation. Jesus has come to strengthen the weak. Okay? I alone am... Well, let me call it, I said, I'm weak, but now I'm more than through the plus of the cross, I'm more than a conqueror. And I'm weak, but I can say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You see, please receive that in your heart. Let me tell you a little African story. You know, I've spent my life in Africa. I love Africa. All my dear Africans watching here, you have a very special place in my heart. But also, I must say, also, I've preached in so all over the world, and I love all of God's people, all, no matter whom. He loves you. You know what it means to be a Christian? When you become a Christian, you hate what God hates. What does God hate? God hates sin. And you love what God loves. You love all people. this is just a little side issue, but it is a very bombastic and major thing. We love what God loves, for God so loved the world. We have no enemy, only the devil. But God loves people. He died for the West. Now, let me tell you that African little story. I know it sounds like a children's story, but it has also an adult application. Okay? Listen. They say there was a mighty elephant. An African elephant is the biggest elephant in the world. And he wanted to cross a shaky bridge. And there was a tiny little ant. And that ant sat on the ear of a mighty elephant. And then the elephant put the first foot on the bridge, and the bridge began to move. The other one, it shook. And so he went forward, and the bridge was shaking. And then all of a sudden they were on the other side, and the little ant scratched the ear of the elephant and said, "Elephant, you and I, we both shook the bridge." Do you get the point? You may be weak, but there is a plus. There is addition. You plus Jesus equal the strong. That's why the Bible says, the weak shall say, "I am strong." Can you see how it all connects? The weak shall say, "I am strong." The sick shall say, "I am healed." The sinful shall say, "I am saved, Lord. And I thank you for it from the bottom of my heart." Amen. Don't forget the cross. The cross is a plus, God's plus for you. Amen. It is a plus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And he paid at the cross for our sin with his precious blood. The blood was the price. With the blood, he reconciled us with God in heaven when he ascended. And with his blood, he is able and willing, more than willing and more than able, to wash us, to cleanse us from all sins, according to 1 John 1, verse 7. Amen. Isn't that glorious? It is absolutely, I think it is absolutely wonderful. And that is open to you now. Not only salvation and forgiveness, but also healing. Yes, I tell you, I have been reading your comments. They come in by the thousands. And I have been sitting and reading half a day to pray, to read, to try to pronounce your names whenever I could. And I said, "Lord, these are precious people. You love them. I love them too, because I have the Spirit of Christ in me." And now I'm asking you to heal the sick. Let the river flow. I can feel how the river of God flows. By his stripes we are healed. You may be at the very verge of death, or maybe your child in a hospital, or maybe your husband, or maybe your grandparents, or somebody has been in an accident, and you cry to God to save his life. I cry with you in the name of Jesus, Lord. Save that son from dying and give him life to fulfill his days and his life in full, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Can you feel the Holy Spirit? He's here. He's really here. He's really here. I walk with him. I talk with him. He speaks to me. I can feel him. And that's why I know I have the authority to come against every work of Satan in Jesus' name. Cripples walk in Jesus' name. Get out of your wheelchair in Jesus' name. Rise from your sick bed in Jesus' name, no matter where you are, at home or in hospital or where you are or in a nursing place. In the mighty name of Jesus, you shall be healed in Jesus' name. Amen. Those of you who would like to exchange your minus for a plus, your sin for salvation, please receive Jesus now. Will you? I love to pray with you. I long to pray with you. And I believe the Lord is right there with you. He says, I'm with you always till the end of the earth. So I don't mind where you are. Jesus is right there where you are. Geographically, we are separated, but not spiritually. Holy Spirit is right here, as he is with you now. And he is the breaker of all bondage. The plus, remember? Every day, he is adding himself to you. He is adding himself to you, and you are not alone. The weak shall say, I am strong. And I tell you, if you have understood what I said, I need to tell you this. You may have never shaken a bridge, but as of today, you will shake the bridge with Jesus. Until now, you may not have succeeded, even at school. Today, if the cross adds Jesus to you, the plus sign, you will be the best in class. You shall not be the tail, you shall be the head in Jesus' name. Amen. I've got another thing I would like to say. I have heard so many prayer requests. I read them. I saw people crying tears. I want to say to young ladies who are looking for a husband, the Lord will give you a Christian husband. I want to say to the young men who are looking for a wife, the Lord will give you a Christian wife. Do you hear? He will make you cross her path, or she will cross your path. Shall I pray for you? I pray for you. He will do so and will fulfill the desire of your heart. Oh Lord, please, I pray for everyone. I pray for those girls who are at marriageable age. I pray that they may not go into the shadows just to look for someone, that they may look for a Christian husband, that you will make them pass their paths in Jesus' name and recognize each other as being sent by the Lord. Lord, anoint their eyes to see and give strength to them to speak up in Jesus' name. And I believe there will be many marriages just around the corner and many, many happy, blessed, God-blessed families in Jesus' name. Are you happy? Oh, hallelujah. I love it. Now, if you want to receive Jesus, show me your hand. If you want to receive Jesus, I know I can't see your hand, but God does. And he needs to see your hand. Lord, here. Here am I. All alone right now. But I need you. I need you to help to get rid of my minus. You need to cross now through my minus and turn it into this plus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. The Bible says, in Romans, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You are one whosoever, as I also was one such whosoever. It's the greatest word in the Bible, I think. Whosoever. In the Old Testament, it was all Israel. Israel. Yes, they are chosen people. But when the New Testament opens, a new word appears, world, world. God didn't just love Israel, although he does, but the New Testament, for God so loved the world. He said, go into all the world, and that's where all the whosoevers are, you and me. Please repeat this prayer, this moment, and you will have a vertical connection with the throne of God. Okay? Stretch out your hand and repeat this prayer after me. Lord Jesus Christ, I bring my minus to you, my ugly minus of sin and bondage. Oh, Jesus, just put it through, just add your vertical beam to turn my minus into a plus. And then add yourself, Lord, to my life, to my marriage, to my family, and let peace come into my house and to my neighbors and to everyone. And let your peace, your peace, pass my understanding. I receive, I believe, and I know you will do it this very, very moment. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen. So, please don't forget this message. Tell it to other people. Say, God is here. Jesus is here to cut through your minus and turn it into a plus. He turns hell to heaven. He turns sadness, depression, mental problems into brightness, into joy, into the joy of the Lord, which will be your strength. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, let me say this. I have to finish now, but let me say this. I've got this book of mine here called Even Greater. I don't know whether it shows the title properly. I hope so. Even Greater. These are 12 real life stories that will inspire you to do great things of God. I've written this book, and this book is my own experience. You will be amazed, even greater. You can get it right now in audio. Audio, Amazon Audio, Kindle or whatever you call it, wherever you are. It's cheaper in Amazon and Audible. It's cheaper. You will get it and you can have it in the next 5 minutes. So please do it. I recommend it highly. And I'm sure when you start, you won't be able to finish, okay? I'm not a salesman. I'm not a businessman at all. I've got the heart full of love for you. I wish I could give it all away free of charge. I can't, of course, I can't. But you will add a great blessing to your life. It's like a building block. Get this book. There are other books of mine, like Living a Life of Fire, my autobiography, and it's just wonderful. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sierra Leone. I see Sierra Leone. Yes. Amen. Amen. God bless you. These wonderful nations where I have been before and preached the gospel. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. And now I have to knock off. But I trust that you will save this and send it to others who need it, who need their minds to be broken and turned into a plus, and then get a ride with Jesus and get victory with Jesus. God bless you. I love you all. And as soon as I possibly can, I will come back and continue on the same theme, because this is such a vast theme. The cross of Christ. With all my love to you, to your family, and to everyone, God bless you. God bless you.